people, welcome to an amazing time with me. My name is Chacha Wabara, and if you haven't subscribed, please do hit on the subscribe button. Do turn off your post notifications so that you'll be alerted when a new video comes up. Yeah, today we'll be reviewing a Korean drama known as Squid Game. It's a 2021 Netflix drama.
Oh,
9 episodes. This drama right now is now number 1 in US alone. It has left Korea, it has entered the US, so it has replaced Sweet Home. That's to show you how good the drama is. It has amazing actors and actresses like Lee Jung Jae, Park Hae-Soo, Woo Ha-jun, Hong Jung Soo, and Jung Ho-Yeon. Okay, I don't know, interpret it any way you want to interpret it. I've said my own. You people know that I'm reviewing the drama known as Squid Game. So this guy, everything he did would just never used to work. He had an old mom who was still moving around trying to make ends meet. He would make money, he would squander the money, gambling and all of that. So at one particular time, after seeing his daughter, he wanted to take a train back home, and then he meets this guy who says, okay, let's play a short game. If you win 100 grand, and they started slapping each other, and at the end he was given this offer of to play games, and then he will win a whole lot of money to offset his bills, to pay off his debts, because he was knee deep in debt and he had gotten the last warning, and so he agreed. But then when he was going, they had a way that they communicated that they were ready to go, or he communicated that he was ready to go. And as he got to the blindfolded them and all of that, as he got to the venue, he saw that he was not just the only person playing that game. As a matter of fact, he was the last person, number 456, and there were 456 people who had come from different places, who had gone through the same thing that he went through, to play that game so that they can make money. At the end of the day, after the first game, over 200 people lost that game. And losing that game does not just mean that you're just going to go home and buy. You're going to die. So as soon as you lose the game, you're killed. And then this old man that was the main lead's friend, he said he had 2 more and he was losing his memory and all of that. He now also met his neighbor's son, who was like the star of the neighborhood, a financial whiz kid. He was knee deep in debt. He was owing over $600 and something million dollars. And Everybody just had their financial trouble, and he was like, oh wow. So when these 200 and something people died, a whole lot of people voted against continuing with the game, so everybody left. Later on, everybody left and went back to their screwed up lives, and they got this invite again, and they were like, you know what, let me just go play the game, whether I die or not, maybe I might have a chance at winning. So those same people, like 89 of them, came back to play this game, and it was crazy, a whole lot of crazy. There was this other girl that came from North Korea and was fighting, and there were these touts, you know. At some point, it was like man eat man. Everybody was struggling to survive. People lost their humanity, and it was nothing short of changing people to animals. They kept on fighting, and the curious thing was that inside where they were sleeping, the money just comes rolling down like it's in a ball, and you keep staring at the money, which is like an incentive to move, to keep moving, to keep playing, to whatever the consequence, whether you're dying or you're not dying. After all, going out of the house or out of the game meant going back to that situation that you avoided. So what's the need? Those different stages in the game, and they were asked to play children's games. So let's just say people like me now, that I don't know how to play any children's game, I can't remember children's game, you know, you have to be, you know, light thinking in your head. So that financial guru or whatever that was the main lead's neighbor, he show, you know, that place exposes you or makes you confront your humanity, makes you confront who you really are, whether you're a miserable person, whether you are a conscienceless person, whether you are just a nasty, mean person. You will see it there. They found themselves killing each other, and at the end of the day, the main lead became the winner after a gruesome fight. The old man that was there, who was the man's friend and all that, lost to him or made him win and left. So he was supposedly killed, but at the end of the day, when he got the money, when he got over 400 and something billion won, he just couldn't spend the money. He was looking at the money, you know, he was torn apart. He lodged the money there, he did not spend the money, and blah blah blah. Now fast forward to the end of this movie, I'm thinking, okay, this is what we have now, what's going on? He now starts to look for those who are playing the game, telling them stop playing the game. And for crying out loud, I don't understand that part at all. This is not something that usually happens with Korean movies or Korean drama. Korean dramas don't end like Nigerian dramas or Nigerian movies. So I found it really annoying, especially when he got to know that the old man actually did not die. He was a very wealthy man and all of that. He had this righteous indignation and now went back, took someone else's invite and indicated interest to go back to play that Squid game. After all the trauma he went through, after all the pain he went through, he actually went back or indicated interest to go back into the house. So what am I saying now? What I'm saying is that the movie did not end in the way it ought to end. I'm saying that because you cannot just keep someone on a rigmarole and all of that, and then you are going through the same thing over and over. What message are you trying to pass across? I would prefer how the movie started to even almost episode 9, which was the last episode, but that singular end of the movie wasn't what I was just looking forward to. Aside that, the cinematography was awesome, the sound was wonderful, the lighting was wonderful, the effects used, I don't know how they did all those games, you know, they made it look like a child's kiddies playhouse being used, and then that setup of homes, of neighborhood homes, you know, it was awesome. At some point, I actually thought that they were going to say that the old man was the main lead's father, but it didn't happen like that. So I was like, okay, fine and good. So at the end of the day, I wasn't really too happy with the way the movie ended. Apart from that, there's no problem with the drama at all. It's an amazing watch. So I'm going to be rating this drama an 8/10, which brings me to the end of this Korean movie review. Out there, you see my Korean movie review, my Chinese movie review, my Nigerian movie review, and my movie reviews. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for doing this with me. Till I see you next time, it's bye for me. Bye. Thank you so much.